Before I get into my prepared remark, I would just like to comment on the response you gave to the young man who advocates for disabled people. When you answered his question, you talked more about debt and the deficit more than you talked about the fact that the votes that you made regarding health care impact the lives of people. Now, I understand that debt and deficit is a problem. I mean, that's fine. It's not worth people's lives. And in my family, I have a younger brother who has a genetic problem that he's had since he was 3. And to put the debt reduction or deficit reduction over his well-being is garbage to me. I don't think there's any tools or programs that assist disabled people, poor people, really should be used to tackle a problem that none of them really created.
Well, let me just respond to that. I have a father and a sister that are disabled. And so if my comments came out wrong, I apologize. What I'm trying to say is we need a strong economy for job opportunities for people. So again, it's certainly not, I didn't mean any disrespect.
I didn't take it as disrespect. I just thought it was that you just talked about debt and deficit. You didn't say that, you know, we really do need to focus on making sure that, you know, like my brother, his condition, he went through puberty when he was 3 years old. He almost died from it. And to sit there, or I shouldn't say sit there, but to say that, you know, Medicaid that he relies on because his body is obviously very damaged, to take Medicaid and reduce it in the process of trying to, you know, maybe knock the debt or the deficit down a little bit. I really don't care about the debt deficit when it comes to the health and well-being of my brother who works 30 hours a week, earning minimum wage, stuffing envelopes at a company here in Fargo. You know, he's doing his part. He's not just laying around his house doing nothing, or, you know, as I'm not saying that you have done that. There have been several Republicans who like to talk about the welfare queens or, you know, the lazy people. And like I said, it's not you, you know, it's others I've heard. Those, the people that need help. And to take and reduce debt and deficit on the backs of people who have a genetic condition is just, should not be done that way. To get on the train of HCR 34, which I know you have said that it, in the Medicare section, doesn't say anything about turning into a voucher program, but that's the plan. Just because the bill doesn't say it, doesn't mean that's not what Paul Ryan's plan is, because that's what Paul Ryan's plan is. He has said as much. And the reason this is important to me is because I have both my parents and my mother-in-law turn 53 this year. All of the money that they have paid into that system is basically going to be taken away from them. And like I said before, my brother relies on Medicaid, and to turn it into basically a block grant program, which is once again Paul Ryan's plan, to turn Medicaid into a block grant program where states have to make a decision of this program versus the health and well-being of its citizenry is should not be the way that things are run. I spent some time last night and I watched all of your campaign ads that you ran in the campaign against Pomeroy. And in four separate ads, four of them, you said that you opposed the $500 billion defense of Medicare that the Affordable Care Act contained, even though that's really not $500 billion in cuts, it's more of reductions in benefits or in spending. You know, you were against Medicare cuts in the campaign, but now you voted for HCR 34, which essentially will take Medicare apart. And at the same time, I know you've said that they're going to close loopholes to reduce the tax rates from 35 to 25, but the fact of the matter is that the people that are getting reduced from 35 to 25 are the people that can afford to have it be kept at 35 and have the loopholes closed. You know, I mean, these are people like yourself who, I mean, you're worth $20 million. So, in another ad, you said that when you get to Washington, you would do things the North Dakota way. I just want to know how doing things the North Dakota way is taking from the elderly, the disabled, and the poor, and lining the pockets of the top percentage.
Okay. I'm not sure which question I have. First of all, I'd like to say, to be clear, Medicaid and Medicare go up in the budget proposal that was passed. The dollars go up, they don't go down. You're right about the $500 billion coming out of Medicare. So again, the question is, how do we move this forward? And I want to make sure that you understand there's several different things that are getting, sometimes get twisted up. One, Paul Ryan had a plan, a roadmap, America, something he put together. It was a voucher system. What's being talked about here is a system similar to the healthcare plan that all congressmen and their staff have, where people pick from different options, and that's part of the, you know, but again, I appreciate your perspective.